leave all the rest of the setting as they are. On the edge, you got gray on the left, and then drag it to the center and right at the far end. Slightly fading gray on luminosity. Again, create it there and bring it to the center. Leave white on the far end. For color mix, light gray on the far right hand and white right up to the center. For color, black on the right and white on the left. And on the noise, fractal 100% for regularity, 0% for growth, grow radius, scale 300, peak blend 80%, detail 5%, phase 590%, gain 60, bias 50, low threshold 20, and high threshold 100. And that's basically it for the materials. Open up, unfold it all. You can quickly unfold it by your right click on the wheel and then go to unfold all here, or if you want to fold it up, fold all here. That's quite useful thing to use. So you need to add the sparks material to the sparks emitter and the smoke material to the smoke emitter, which is the moment turned off. Do the same for the other rocket, sparks and smoke. Now quickly play the animation, freeze it up, move it further back so you can view all the particles, and press render, and then you got the particles. Also, if you watch the particles as they hit the floor plane, there is a slight bounce from the deflector. You don't need more than that. If you want to increase the bounce, just go to deflector, bounce, and increase it by 1% or 2%. Turn on the smoke and just watch what happened to some of the particles. They get blown by the wind. It's these on the edge here. If the effect is not the desired effect, just go to the wind and increase the wind speed to 7 or even 8. As you can see, the wind here is pointing the wrong way, so that's the reason why we're not seeing the effect here. Now if you play the animation, you'll see that some of the particles getting blown further away. If we do a quick, we won't do a full render because it'll take a while. We'll do a region render. That's a useful thing when you only want to see the effect on some of the particles rather than render the whole scene. Okay, what's missing here is the lights. So quickly create a light, reduce the strength to about 30, go to the move tool and add this light. You need two lights added to the rockets to increase the brightness of the smoke and the particles, and just place it there. Just control drag this light to duplicate it, and again place the second one roughly where the emitter is. The other thing you can do to the light, if you want to increase the visibility of the smoke, we'll create another light here, which will be the scene light, and drag it towards you and up. I'll just show you the effect. Once you add the light to the scene, just increase this one to about 60%, and on this light go to the shadow and from the list choose soft shadow map. Once you created the lights, select them both and parent them to the wheel, anywhere on the wheel or to individual rocket. That will brighten up the visibility of the smoke. Again, use a render region. Turn the smoke on, the render time will increase. As you can see from this area render, there is smoke showing there, but the smoke that's been blown away disappeared. If you want to increase the visibility of the smoke as it's gets blown away, what you could do is go to the smoke emitter and on the lifetime increase the lifetime to 80 frame. Play the animation again, we'll see the difference now. Now do another render region. This time we'll take closer to the rocket. It's still rendering, but as you can see here already, we are able to see the particles at the far edge of the smoke. So if you want to see more of the smoke, obviously that will slow down your render, just increase the lifetime. Okay, we'll do a full preview now of this particular scene, and when it's finished I'll come back and show you the result. Okay, a few things you need to do before we watch the preview is play the animation, and as you can see the wheel starts turning before the sparks and smoke appearing. So simply, because we set the sparks to start the mission in 20, frame 20, and the smoke, frame 20, we now need to click on the wheel null object, and the keyframe we created was on 0, so basically just drag it to frame 20 or even 21. So the wheel start turning slightly after the rocket starts, because the wheel is powered by the rockets itself. So it's up to 20, maybe 21, 22 to make it more realistic. So the rocket starts and then the wheel start turning. And that's basically it. The other thing is, if, as you noticed, our plane haven't got material added to it, so just create any material that you would like it to be and add to it. And now basically it's complete, and you can see the sparks at the bottom hitting the plane and bouncing. If the deflector is too small, just increase the deflector size to contain the particles. Okay, I hope you found this tutorial useful, and don't forget to watch the rest of my tutorials on Digital Visions Tutorial .blogspot.com. Thank you.